Okay, so just a little intermezzo for the next bigger block. I'm going to talk a tiny bit about MQTT, because there is like an MQTT object in TouchDesigner now, and for those of you who have been at the summit, maybe remember how Achim Kern, who is also the course where this is in TouchDesigner, introduced MQTT, and at that time I was a bit overwhelmed, didn't quite understand.
You're using it too now.
So I tried to figure it out for myself, and that's how far I got. So MQTT seems to make a lot of sense for controlling installations or controlling installations where you have to deal with different devices. It's a protocol. It's called protocol, coming from the world of IoT, Internet of Things, so it has a very small footprint, and it is ideal if you have several things which all need, for example, if you have an installation, like they used it in the telecom gallery in Cologne, where they have like a big demo space with lots of screens, lots of media players, interactive stuff, and so on. And it's not public, they use it for customers. So whenever a group of customers come, they come from different industries, so they prepare the whole exhibition for that specific group of customers. And for that, they use MQTT, so that every device, every media player, blah, 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 they all get the info how, in which state they should be on that day. I was recently also working on a project where afterwards we thought it would have been pretty smart to use this MQTT. The idea is that you have client and server. So the server would be an MQTT server. There is a public MQTT test servers. So I'm going to use this one here, broker.hivemq.com. So you can open that up in your browser. You can use, if you don't have your own internet, you can use this Wi-Fi. The thing is, this mobile, I'm not so sure how good it will hold up if all 20 of you use it and start downloading Facebook updates and stuff. So if you have an own internet source, maybe use that or just watch the news. Anyway, it's going to be more of a walkthrough. However, the idea is that this broker, which you can also then for own installations install on a local machine in your network, so the whole thing works on the network, but it doesn't have to go over the internet. Even so, we're using this test server over the internet. And the broker is basically a server, and the idea is that the clients connect to that server, or in the MQTT speech, it's also not a server, it's a broker. And the clients subscribe to topics. So you as a client can find a topic. Topic could be anything, like it could be a specific failure that you're using, or it could be a specific data source, or whatever. It's just called topics. Or the clients can publish topics to the server, and these topics will be there on the server, and then the clients can subscribe. That means that every client also gets the information that the client needs, because you only subscribe to that. So the server may hold information for 1,000 devices, but every single device gets only what it subscribes to. It doesn't get what it doesn't need to know. And that makes it quite effective. And there is also a mechanism to tell how reliably do you need that message. Is it okay if the package gets lost or not? Or is it absolutely essential that the package comes? And another advantage is that the last value that a topic had is still present on the server. So if you shut down your machine and you boot it up 5 days later, it will still be able to get a state from the server, because the server holds that state from the broker. So you can find out more about MQTT and how it's defined by simply googling MQTT. And this here is like a test server. Basically, if you want to try out, you can just publish to the server. like at the moment is extremely quiet. Usually there's like lots of stuff happening here. Let me see, it's still the same. Okay. So, how does this look on the TouchDesigner side? At the core, there is the MQTT object, so that's a dot object. So this would be the MQTT client. It has here you can add the broker. So in my case, that's this one, this broker Hive MQ, and the port number. This user client ID is not necessarily necessary, but it's also not bad if it's there. Not sure what the keep alive interval does. And then you can connect to that server. So as it's a public server, it's already there, we can definitely do that. Then there is the MQTT client callbacks. So basically what I did here is just put a print in there just to see what is happening. So you can connect. If connection failure happens, it will inform you if connection is lost. If you subscribe to a topic, if you unsubscribe to a topic, and if you start publishing things. So I disabled this because once you start publishing, it prints here all the time. If a message comes in, that will also be printed out. You see here different things that are important for MQTT. So you have to define, this duck, I think, is just this operator, but then topic, that is the topic of that message. The payload is the actual message, and that has to be binary in MQTT, binary data. Then the QoS is quality of service. I think this comes with a number. The higher the number, the more emphasis is on that you actually get that message. How exactly these numbers, what they exactly mean, you can read in the MQTT documentation. But I think if you have a 3, it's guaranteed that the message arrives. This is a 1. If necessary, it can also not arrive. Which will also mean if connection is lost, that as soon as connection is back, all the messages that have been, well, that have this high priority and haven't been delivered yet, that they will all come. So they not get lost in comparison to if that happens with OSC, whatever happened in the meantime is gone. But here it will go through all of that. So it's very good if you want to have reliable results. So here comes in the message in binary. Check that out here. And I created here like a little test setup where I compare the live data with the data from the broker. So we can see the delay once we're connected. These are all two other useful links. You will find this file in the workshop file, so you can check that out. So here on the left, there are different scripts that will do what we need to do. So now it says we have lost the connection. I don't know why, so I'm going to connect again. Connected. So now we could publish something to the server and see if it comes out there. So I use the topic NXT Here it says basically this variable R is the operator MQTT client receives, that is the MQTT client. Okay, let's first subscribe to this MXT topic, because then we're also going to see what's happening. So basically, you just tell the MQTT object subscribe, and then there's a string, the topic which I'll subscribe to. So when I run the script, we start receiving something. That is because I already published something over here, so maybe I should stop that for now. So now we subscribe to this MXT topic, so everything that will be published from whoever under this topic will also be received by us. If I want to unsubscribe from that topic, I just have to run this script which says unsubscribe from that topic. So this one is basically to test how I have to format information to publish it, because wasn't so clear how I turn stuff into binary data in TouchDesigner. So I'm still not sure, but my guess was from the script that I found is that by having this B here in front of that string, that becomes binary. I conclude that from the fact that when I delete that B, it doesn't work. So the B seems to be important. There's this B and we have to do binary. I think it makes something into binary. Maybe Marcus can say that this is a Python command to turn that into binary data.
Binary string.
So. Somehow. I'm constantly losing connection. I don't know why. It may have something to do with this internet here, because when I tried it at home, I never lost connection. Obviously, you could write a little script in the callbacks, which if connection is lost, re-establish connection, which I didn't do in this example yet. So what I did to test it is to just take a noise value, for which I can here also change the sample rate, because it's not made for super high frequent updates. It's quite fast, but it's not really meant to have super high frequent updates, so that's why I change the noise only ever so often. And here, basically, I take that noise value, and then I compose the message by adding that key together with that noise value, which I turn into a string. And also took me a bit to figure out how to do that. So what I did is I used these single quotes to add double quotes in the string, and then I published this. So here I need an eval to get the right format out of that message. Excuse me if I formulate it like this, because I don't really understand the whole logic behind it. So it's a bit hacky. But if you use that eval, you get the message in the right format. I have a quality of service of 1, because it doesn't really matter. And this retain means that the message is going to stay on the server, so that the next time that I connect, this will be still there. And if you say false here, then the server actually forgets about it. So next time will be a fresh start. So let's see. We are again disconnected. So what should happen now is that this noise gets published and then I get it back from the server for whatever reason.
Like nochmal subscribe disconnected.
Oh yeah, okay. So it would be probably very wise to have in the callback script that says if connection is lost, reconnect and resubscribe to the topic and so on. But what I found quite interesting is, so basically this is now the signal local, and this is the signal coming back from the broker. And most of the time it seems to be quite in time, so there's no visible time shift. So basically I use this to control these two circles, and if the signals are absolutely equal, we should never see the red circle, because then the green circle would be over the red circle, so both of them have the same information at the same time. And you see that most of the time there's no real delay between the broker and the local signal. Yeah, the part that I haven't tried out yet, which is like the next step, is to install a local MQTT server, though that we're not depending on that public server anymore. And considering that we send this now over the mobile through the internet, the delay is really good. So I assume if you're in a local network, it's not feelable anymore. And that's pretty much it. So that's how you get it to work. Based on that, I think you can easily make your own application of this. And I've been talking to Peter, who said he's using MQTT a lot with local install, and he said it's very easy and not a problem at all. So I trust him on that. I'm gonna try it at home. That's pretty much it. Do you have questions? Good. One of them can answer. No? Yeah, cool. So then basically just take this component and try it out if it does anything good for you. And thank you.